Dan Illman, Mike Buehr. It's Queen's Plate Sunday at Woodbine, and race number 9 is a graded stakes race. Let's throw up the field for the dance smartly. Fillies and mares going a one-turn mile and a quarter on the E.P. Taylor turf course. Did I mention it's a $250,000 guaranteed pool in the pick five? It kicks off with this race. The two big names in this race are coming up from the States. The 6, Muda Makina for trainer Christophe Clement. The 5, Etoile for trainer Chad Brown. They're legitimate graded stakes horses. Etoile especially won the grade 1 E.P. Taylor 2 back over this course and distance. Am I being a little bit silly or naive in saying that I may not necessarily trust either one?
No, I don't think so. I mean, I think they're the, you know, certainly the two right favorites in here. They have the credentials to be made the prices that they are on the morning line, Dan. But I also don't think either one of them is, you know, so scary that you can't go looking for other horses in here.
A concern for both might be the pace scenario. I know Etoile and Muta Makina have been close to the pace. Let's throw up that time form U.S. pace projector. Al Nassim is stretching out in distance. Went gate to wire, 2 back and a 2 other than at Churchill Downs. Blame Debbie controlled glacial fractions in winning the searching 2 starts back. I think this might be up for grabs, Mike. Merville Yeux even has a little bit of speed.
Yeah, it'll be interesting to see the tactics that these riders decide to use in here. If nothing else, Dan, when I looked at it anyway, the one thing that I didn't think would happen would be that either the 5 or the 6, the 2 favorites, would necessarily be compromised no matter how it's run. I didn't really feel like, you know, either one of these mares was, you know, sort of dependent on having the right trip.
Blame Debbie, the number 1, really got good when trainer Graham Motion stretched her all the way out in distance. She seems to appreciate these races at 10 furlongs or greater, and she got an easy trip when she won the searching off a long layoff. They just let her go 55 to the half, and she sprinted on home. Last time out, she caught soft going, and she also caught a runaway leader. It was a different pace scenario. I don't think she ran badly, though.
Yeah, I don't either. It was just a totally different kind of race, and it was actually a pretty good field, too. I think, you know, some of those horses have already run back, and they've run well. There was even an also-ran who came back to win really impressively at Saratoga on Friday. So that's been a pretty good race. It feels like this is a spot where Blame Debbie fits right in. She can get any kind of a trip in a race. And as you pointed out, since they've stretched her out, she's gotten really good.
I might have made a mistake in not upgrading Merville Yeux, one of my favorites in my picks, because I do think she fits on her best day. She is a course and distance winner. She won the Wonder Wear last year. And I wonder if you could make a case for her 2 starts and give her excuses. In the Trillium, she was running off the layoff. She was running on synthetic. And last time out in the Nassau, it was kind of a one-turn mile. I think it's a little short for her. And it was a race that was controlled up front by a nice one in Jolie Olympica.
Yeah, I think that's probably valid. I might have been a little too hard on her in this race, too, because I actually liked her last time. I thought that was a good spot for her in the Nassau last time. At first blush, I was disappointed with how she ran, but maybe she does have an excuse. And, you know, stretching back out in distance for this could really help her.
Another horse making the 3rd start of the form cycle with improving buyers on display, the 3 of Fleet Catherine, runner-up in last year's Woodbine Oaks. Let's watch a Fleet Catherine's most recent start, an optional claimer over the synthetic going a mile and an eighth. She got right up close to the pace in here. She's going to battle it out, and she's going to finish a good 2nd, beaten by a neck. I actually think she might be slightly better on the turf, although I'm not sure about distance.
Yeah, I wonder if, you know, it's certainly when you compare to some of the others, I wonder if stretching out actually helps her in this race. I'll certainly agree with you that maybe she's a better turf horse, and she did run fine last time, but this feels like a tough spot for her.
Al Nassim did go gate to wire 2 starts back at Indiana Grand. Maybe they'll utilize those tactics here. I have distance questions with her as well. She was more of a miler overseas last time out. They ran her in a stakes race at Indiana Grand. She kind of had a look at it in upper stretch, and she finished evenly. Maybe if she gets a nice easy trip on the lead, she can stretch her, perhaps her stretch her distance limitations. Yeah. 6-1 to me seems a little bit light on the tote.
Yeah, I wouldn't take that price on her. I don't necessarily love any of her races since they got her over here. And I know she won that race wire to wire 2 starts back then. I don't see her getting that trip in this race.
Etoile got a perfect trip when she won the E.P. Taylor last year, going a mile and a quarter. She just tucked in behind the lead in the pocket behind a slow pace. She eased out 3 furlongs to go, and she was able to hold off Court Return, who's also in here. And then she disappeared, so something must have happened. Etoile came back in the Jenny Wiley, a grade 1 at Keeneland. a race with no pace whatsoever. She didn't break well. She tried to come from last. She had no chance.
Yeah, I mean, I guess that's true. You know, it was off the layoff in there. So, you know, getting that trip and her first start back over yielding turf, there are plenty of excuses that you could make for her, for that Jenny Wiley. The question is she the kind of horse you want to be making excuses for, Dan? She's going to be a really short price in this race. And I know that she won the EP Taylor last year, but, you know, which one of her races, you know, really stands out in here that makes you feel like she's supposed to be a really short price in this race?
The last time Muta Makina raced with Lasix, she won the Grade 3 Long Island with a perfect trip and ride for Dylan under Dylan Davis, saving ground and then shooting through along the inside when the gap opened up in mid-stretch at the Big A. She's reunited with Dylan here. This is a mare who showed surprising speed last time out in the River Memories and hung in very gamely. She's a tough mare.
Yeah, she's pretty good. You know, it's funny. I could go either way on her, Dan. I guess it would all depend on price in here. I don't think I'd be betting her as the favorite, but she's actually run some good races since she got over here. You know, in some ways, she might have run the best race in the River Memories last time. She took on a bunch of challenges. It was surprising to see her on the lead anyway. And then she took on a bunch of challenges and only got run down late by a horse who sat a perfect trip behind her.
Court Return ran second in the EP Taylor at a huge price. That race didn't come out of nowhere. She was third in the Canadian at a huge price before that. She seems to get into form in the fall. Her last race, though, I think was a decent prep. The issue with her is she rarely wins races, and she likely needs a little bit of pace help. But you can use her at a price underneath.
I looked at her the exact same way. I don't know that I necessarily want to bet her in here, but I could use her somewhere because I do think with her best race and the right trip, she can certainly be competitive in here.
Taking a look at our top picks for the Grade 2 Dance Smartly, while I'm not sure I completely trust the favorites, they do have a big advantage on a speed figure standpoint. And Etoile especially, I think, was compromised by the most recent race. And her ability over this course, I think, might help her get over the hump. I like what you're doing with Blame Debbie. She has tactical speed. You've always liked her. She's a proven graded stakes horse. She might even get the jump on Etoile turning for home.
Yeah, I thought maybe she could fall into a trip here. And she'll just be a little bit of a better price than the two favorites. Again, I'm not way against the five or the six. They're not superstars. They're not horses I'm afraid to bet against. I'm going to try to out-trip them with the one.
1-6, 5-7 for Mike. 5-6, 4-2 for me. It's the Grade 2 Dance Smartly. We're kicking off a $250,000 guaranteed pool in the 20-cent pick five. Good luck.